Welcome back to this class. In this class, we will see electrocyclic reactions from unit number 6. Normally, electrocyclic reactions are of two types: electrocyclic opening of the ring and electrocyclic closure of the conjugated systems. They are actually induced either thermally or photochemically. There are two types of induction will be there. They are electrocyclic reactions are concerted interconversion of conjugated polyenes and then cycloalkene. There is an interconversion between cycloalkene and a conjugated polyene systems. I will see some examples of electrocyclic reactions. This is 1,3-butadiene. This is a 4N pi systems on thermal conditions or in the photochemical conditions. It is giving a cyclobutene. Cyclobutene, this is a pi system. It's a 4 pi systems. It will give the only 1 pi systems. This is another examples. This is 1,3,5-triene system. 1,3,5-triene. This on photochemical conditions or in the thermal conditions, it is giving a diene with one sigma bond, with one addition sigma bond. Here also one addition sigma bond will be there. One pi bond will be reduced, one extra sigma bond will be there. Here also one pi bond will here 4n minus 2 pi electron. Here 6,3 pi systems will be there. Minus 2, it will give 2 pi systems with one addition sigma bond will be there on cyclizations. So another example is the cyclopropenyl propenyl cation. And propenyl cation is also a 4 pi systems on cyclization. This is on both thermal condition and in the photochemical conditions. On both thermal and the photochemical conditions, it will undergo cyclization, giving a cyclopropenyl cation. This is also a 4n pi minus 2 pi system. One pi electron will be removed plus one addition sigma bond will be there. So these are the examples of the electrocyclic reactions. Now we'll see in detail about these electrocyclic reactions. So we have seen that electrocyclic reactions are electrocyclic opening reactions and the electrocyclic closure of the conjugated system. These are the two types. They are induced by thermal conditions and in the photochemical conditions. There are two types of electrocyclic pi systems will be there. The number of pi systems, if the pi system is 4n, there are two types of pi systems. If the pi system is 4n, on the mode of activation, in thermal activation, it will undergo bond rotations. On a 4n pi systems, on a thermal condition, it will undergo bond rotations. The 4n pi systems, on the photochemical condition, it will undergo this rotation. So likewise, this is another pi systems, 4n plus 2 pi systems. This 4n plus 2 pi systems on thermal conditions, it will undergo this rotations. On 4n plus 2 pi systems on a photochemical conditions, it will give con rotations. It will undergo reaction by con rotations. So now this rotations, con rotations decided based on the HOMO of the intermediate systems. Likewise here, on here, this is 1,3-butadiene. See here, this is 1,3-butadiene. Here one double bond will be there, here one double bond will be here. On the HOMO, highest occupied molecular orbital, on the highest occupied molecular orbitals, it will be like this. On a thermal condition, this HOMO is in the C2 symmetry. So on the bond formation, it should also give the C2 symmetry to make a bond formation. So on the thermal conditions, this undergo a con rotation. Con rotation means if this carbon is rotating in the clockwise direction, this carbon will also rotate in the clockwise directions. If this is in the anticlockwise, this carbon will also rotate in the anticlockwise. So likewise, if it rotate in the same directions, it will give the C2 symmetry. Here the HOMO is also before the con rotations, it is also in C2 symmetry, and after the con rotations, it will also in C2 symmetry. So on a 4 pi systems in a thermal conditions, it will give the con rotations. Likewise for a 4n pi systems in a photochemical conditions, the photochemical conditions, the HOMO will be like this. It is M symmetry. That means a mirror plane will be there. This portion will be reflected by, if a mirror plane will be there, this portion is reflected by this portions. So it is a M symmetry. This M symmetry, this is on a photochemical conditions. on this ensemble tree, this on this rotation, if this carbon is rotating in clockwise direction, this it rotate in the anti-clockwise directions, so that it will also give the same ensemble tree in the after this rotations. So both before the rotations and after the reactions, both the HOMOs will be in the same symmetry. So this under this rotations, if this carbon is rotating in the clockwise direction, this other carbon will be rotating in the anti-clockwise directions. So these are the basis for the this rotations and the con rotations. So now we'll see some electrocyclic reactions types. The first reaction is electrocyclic ring closure reactions by diens. This is 2, this is first carbon, 1 2 3 4 5 6, this is the 2 and fourth carbon, second and the fourth carbon, a diene will be the this is the 4 pi system on a thermal condition, 4 pi system on thermal conditions, it will undergo con rotations. On con rotations, this carbon will rotate in the, if this carbon is rotating in the clockwise direction, this carbon will also rotate in the clockwise directions. So this methyl group will go up and this methyl group will go down. So it will give a trans isomer. But in the second case, if it is in the photochemical conditions, it has to give this rotations. For a 4 pi systems, in a photochemical conditions, it has to give this rotation. This rotation means, if this carbon is rotating in the clockwise direction, this has to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction for a this rotation. So the methyl group will go up, and here the methyl group also will go up. So it will give the cis isomer, but in the thermal condition, it will give the trans isomer. So this is the major difference between con rotation and this rotations. Now we'll see the same thing for the electrocyclic reactions of allyl carbanions. Earlier we have seen the allyl carbocation. Here we have seen the carbanion. This is for the allyl system, allyl carbanion. This is also a 4 and pi system conjugated system. 4 and pi conjugated system. For this, for a 4 and pi system, on a thermal condition, it will undergo con rotations. On a photochemical condition, it will undergo this rotation as we have seen already. If this on con rotation, if this methyl group, this methyl is rotating clockwise, this will also clockwise. So this is giving a trans isomer of the carbanion, of the propenyl anion. So this will give the trans isomer. Now I'll see the next question. The electrocyclic ring closure of the 1,3,5,7 cyclooctatetraene, or otherwise you will take this example. Consider 2E4Z6Z8E 2,4,6,8-decatetraene. Here on double bond will be here. We have given only the HOMO. Instead of a double bond, you have given the HOMO. Here one E conformations in the second conformation. This is the first carbon. The second carbon E conformation will be the here Z. Here also Z. In the eighth carbon, it is also E conformations will be the. So this is the 4 pi system. So because there are 8 pi electrons are there, this is the 4 pi system, 4N pi system. On a 4N pi systems, on a thermal conditions, it will undergo con rotations. For a 4N pi system, on a thermal condition, it will undergo con rotations. For a con rotations, we have seen already, this carbon will rotate, if this is rotating in the clockwise, other will also rotate in the clockwise to form a sigma bond. So the sigma bond is formed between this, because this is also a C2 symmetry. Here also a C2 symmetry after the formation of the bond. So the symmetry will be conserved. So this methyl group will go up. This hydrogen will go up. So giving the trans conformation. This is a trans isomer. This will be equivalent to this. This is a triene system with one sigma bond addition. Here the tetraene system. After the cyclization will give the triene with one sigma bond. This is trans 7-8. Here we have to number from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here the 7th carbon and the 8th carbon are methyl groups. They are in the trans positions. 7th carbon and 8th. We have to number from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For the 7th and 8th, methyl groups are trans. And 1, 2, 3, 4 groups are triene will be there. Cyclotriene will be there. So this is the same group in the photochemical conditions, the same molecule in the photochemical conditions, the HOMO will be like this. Here the HOMO will be in the other way. Here the HOMO in the metasymmetry, M symmetry. That means mirror symmetry will be the, if you put a mirror here, this portion will be reflected by this carbon, this portion. So in the M symmetry on a photochemical conditions, it will undergo this rotations to give the same M symmetry. So here, if this carbon is rotating in the clockwise directions, this carbon has to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction to form a bond between the these two carbons. So this methyl group will go up and this methyl group will go up. So this is giving the cis isomer, for a cis isomer. So that cis 7-8 dimethyl 1,3,5 cyclooctatriene will be the isomer we get from the this rotation on a photochemical condition. So these are the reactions. So now we'll see the one more reactions. This is the TRB questions. Find out the product of the following reaction. This is the TRB question. This was asked earlier. Find out the product of the following reactions. This is the molecule 2E4Z6E. E means trans. Here the this is the first carbon, second carbon. Here the trans conformation will be configuration will be the here trans configuration. This is the second, third, fourth. On fourth is Z configuration. On the sixth, it is also E. Second carbon and sixth carbon are trans, and the fourth carbon is cis. So 2E4Z6E octatriene. It is a non-cyclic molecule on a photochemical conditions. On a photochemical, this is the 4N plus 2. This is 4N plus 2 pi system. This is a 4N plus pi plus 2 pi systems. On a con rotation, it will undergo on a photochemical condition, it will undergo con rotations. On a photochemical condition, it has to undergo the con rotation. Con rotation means if this carbon is rotating clockwise, this will also has to rotate in the clockwise direction. That means if the methyl group is going up, hydrogen will also go up to form the sigma bond between these two carbons. So sigma bond is formed between these two carbons, and a 3 pi system will be reduced to 2 pi system. So and one extra sigma bond will be there, so that this methyl group will go up here and the hydrogen will go down below the paper, and this hydrogen in this carbon, this hydrogen will go up and the methyl group will go down. So these methyl groups are in the trans positions. So the from this we can identify the question answer is trans. We have to number from here, either from here or here. This is if this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 5 and 6 methyl group will be there. So they are in the trans position. So trans 5-6 dimethyl, 5-6 dimethyl, the first position, third position, diene will be there. So the answer will be trans 5-6 dimethyl 1,3 cyclohexadiene will be the answer. If instead of this, if it is in the thermal condition, if it is in the thermal condition, likewise, this is the same isomer in the thermal condition. This is a 4N plus 2 pi system. It will undergo this rotation. On a thermal condition, it will undergo this rotation. This rotation means if this is rotating in the clockwise direction, this has to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction for this rotations. So that if this methyl is going up, this methyl is also go up. So both the methyl groups are above the plane, and the both the hydrogen groups are below the plane. So this is giving the cis isomer. So the answer will be, if it is in the thermal condition, the answer will be cis 5-6 dimethyl 1,3 cyclohexadiene. So these are the things we have seen today. In the next session, we'll see some questions from unit 7. Thank you so much.